That did nothing.
That was actually better. It was good, yeah. Hi, guys.
It is October 7th. We just got done watching our videos going back from the Fleetwood 33C and the Airstream. So we watched, basically comparing the two of the ones that we like the most. We like the Fleetwood Bounder 33C, which is the Class A, the big RV that you drive. And then we like the Airstream 30 Classic, which has basically a little bit more features and it's really dialed in and set up. And I gotta say, after watching the two videos, it kind of confirmed exactly what I was thinking beforehand.
David is all knowing, in case you guys didn't know. We usually get what David wants to get.
No, I'm asking you first. What are your thoughts after watching both videos?
You already know my thoughts. My thoughts are that the Airstream is the way to go. That's all I got.
Well, we've thought about a couple different things, and it actually does make a bit more sense. We are going to have to get a tow vehicle, which we understand, but on the flip side of that, we'll only have to maintain two engines versus three different vehicles, because a Class A will be another vehicle to maintain. It's a lot more simpler with the Airstream, which we like. There's less things to break, less moving pieces, and it's a lot less expensive if something does go wrong. Also, a big factor is we just absolutely believe the Airstream will hold its value better than a Class A will. And it's more of like a, it's more of a collectible, I guess you could say. Like, people always want Airstreams, and you can do more with them, and it's just a classic, iconic piece versus a Class A, which isn't as much. And after 10 years, you know, it's just an older Class A versus an Airstream, which is becomes more of a classic as it ages. So actually kind of gain some absolute value, but just value in general. Plus, on the flip side of that, what we're thinking is, if we do get the Airstream, what we can do is, after we decide we're done with that after a couple years, we could set it up on our property wherever we end up, and then make it into an Airbnb or make it into a little rental and make money back from it. A lot of people are more interested in staying in an Airstream than they will in like staying in a Class A or an RV just parked on a lot. So that'd be really cool. Shake it, decorate it however she wants, make it into a really cute little B&B.
And then whenever we want to go on vacation,
hop it in the truck. And we can keep it for basically as long as we could possibly want, because it'll, you know, as long as we maintain it, it'll be a solid piece. It's a pretty solid structure.
I just think it's the best option for us, especially in the long run. I just don't like how little space there is. But like I've already mentioned, probably like you've already seen, I feel like living in an Airstream is more of an adventure than living in a Class A. And it's like, yeah, I'm home. I have this fireplace and this sectional looking couch, you know, which is great. I'm not trying to diss anybody who does that. But for us, I think it would be better to live in the Airstream because it does feel like you're on a constant adventure.
Yeah, it's a little bit easier to move around. It's smaller. You hook it up and roll out from there. And it fits into what I've seen a lot more national parks and places, so we can actually go a little bit more areas than we could in the Class A necessarily. Plus, it gets better gas mileage towing an Airstream versus driving a Class A, which is also huge. So value, retaining its value, what we could do with it in the long run, keeping it for longer periods of time, less maintenance, less costs, a little bit less space, but it fits more places, we can take it more places. I think it's pretty much a win. It's just a matter of us selling our house. We are putting our house up for sale October 12th, so it'll officially go on the market. We pushed the date back a little bit because we don't want to close before December 18th because we haven't been in our house 2 years yet, so that's kind of our timeline. We'll see what happens. I don't know when this is going to sell or whatnot. And then basically, as soon as it sells, we'll get ourselves an apartment and
get an Airstream.
Yeah, get an Airstream and truck, and then
get a truck, and then we're off.
Yeah, we're gonna figure out what to do from there. So we'll figure out where we're gonna live. We'll probably stay locally for a while and figure that out.
We have to figure out job stuff. He would like to transfer with his job.
Yeah, so that's a huge thing. So we are absolutely wanting to go out of state. We have a couple states in mind. I don't think we've mentioned that yet, so I'm gonna hold off on that for a little while. But we do have some goals on where we want to go and continue our off-road adventures and our new lifestyle adventure too. So hope you guys are enjoying this. It's kind of a quick update. As I mentioned, I'm really excited because I don't know when I'm going to post these. I don't know if I'm going to wait till after we sell it. Probably I'll wait till after we sell our house.
And then we'll start putting them out.
Yeah, slowly. Like, so you'll probably be seeing these after we've already sold our house.
But we're still in the process of buying an Airstream, so we'll slowly catch all up to us actually buying it, and then once we buy it, it'll be live time.
Yeah, it'll be a little bit, yeah, so that'll actually be really cool, because we could look back and be like, that was kind of cool, just kind of the buildup of it and everything too, and kind of figuring everything out.
But we wanted to film these in our real time, so we know exactly how we're feeling in this moment, versus trying to go back 3 months and be like, yeah, I think that's what I remember, so. Mm-hmm.
Little mini time capsules, I guess you could say. Plus, like I said, it would be cool kind of going back and watching these, because at first we were all about, okay, let's do the Winnebago. Okay, let's look at Class A's. We've never been in fifth wheels. It still hasn't come around. We're not going to do that.
It's not an option for us.
But as far as tow vehicles, I think we've talked about it a bit. I think we're going to stick with the diesel option and go that route. I'll look for a 2500, either Chevy or Dodge.
Or a Cummins.
Well, Dodge is a Cummins.
Oh, I thought you said Ford.
No. So we're hopefully going to stick with one of those two. The diesels just tow a lot better. I mean, there's a lot of really good gassers out there now.
And they hold their value better than a gas truck.
So. And the fuel is pretty consistent, too. So I think we're just going to go that route. It's just better torque and stuff like that. We're not going to monster truck it out and just keep it something towing capable. Maybe make it just look a little personal. But other than that, nothing get too crazy.
Nothing fancy.
And she'll basically take over the 4Runner like she has been. And she loves the rig. We love that rig a lot. So we'll just kind of go from there. I'm interested to see how this plays out, because I'm really interested to see how all of this goes out. We're hoping to buy, last note, we're hoping to buy the Airstream, and then pretty much immediately after that, buy the truck, because we don't want to buy the truck first, and then something happen for whatever reason, and not get the Airstream.
Airstream, and then hopefully within that week to 2 weeks, the truck.
We just want to time it so that we do Airstream first, and then truck.
Why buy the horse before the cart?
I was going to say that. That's exactly what I was going to say.
Same person. Also, by the time this video comes out, y'all will have probably seen all of our adventure videos going and checking out different Class A's and different Airstreams.
Oh, that's true. Yep.
We were just watching them. Y'all, I am not materialistic and I am not snobby, I promise. I come off that way a little bit in some of them, and I'm really not. It's kind of bothering me because I'm not that way.
She's just really concerned about us finding something that's going to last. So when she's in these videos and she's talking about quality and stuff like that and how it feels and stuff, her biggest concern is we're going to be living in this, not just using it once every couple months.
Yeah, it has be good quality because we're living in it.
Yeah, and some of these RVs are more set up for, you know, it's living. Not quite the best stuff. It's more set up for just
weekend
using every
getaways.
Now and then.
Yeah.
And not set up for actual, like, daily use.
Yeah, like our camper growing up, it was a Prowler. I don't even know if you guys know what that is, but it had like really cheap carpet and the plastic countertops and everything, but we only took it like once a month. So they weren't looking for quality. It was just something to stay in while we were out camping and stuff. But this is our life.
Yep. And since we're going to be using it consistently, we just want it to be able to last, so we're not like having to replace stuff or break things. Things are going to happen, but we're just trying to make it work and last the most that we can up front. So there you go. I hope that was a better explanation that it was really bothering her watching those videos. And I'll probably edit that in later on anyways. But hope everything's going well. We'll see how all of this turns out. You will know as soon as we do.
I can't wait. I wonder when we're going to post these. Like, is it going to be January, February, May?
As soon as our house sells, who knows?
Who knows?